Okay, thanks for watching. You may want to move this video into full screen mode and change resolution to 720p if it's available to you. And what we're going to do is we're going to turn an HTML based sales page, this one, nice and clean, into a unified page template plugin sales page template format. Bit of a mouthful. Okay, let's go. So what you can see is I've already copied a blocks example.php and an index sales example.php into the folder that we're going to be working with. What we're going to do is we're going to work through the example and use these as our templates. Okay, so let's copy the index.html to there first of all, and we're going to call that index.php, and let's also rename this copy of blocks example to blocks.php, and then what we're going to do is open all three of them in Notepad++. Okay, now the first thing you'll notice is that at the top of the index sales example.php is there's a little bit of code, and we need that to tell the plugin that this is a page template. So we just go into the index.php and we paste that little bit of code in there. The next thing we need is the title, so we're just going to grab that. We're just going to grab that little bit of code there, %% title, and we're going to replace the actual title within there. And then we also need this little bit of code, %% WP head, which is the WordPress function that goes just before the closing head tag. This little snippet, this tag, replaces the usual WordPress PHP code. And then we can get started. So let's just work our way through some of this. And as we go, let's take a look at this. As we go, what we'll be doing is we'll be stripping out some of this regular sales page content, throwing it away, and we'll be turning other parts of it like this into blocks, movable blocks of code. Okay, all will become apparent as we work our way through it. So the first thing we need to do is at the top here we've got div id equals pre-headers. Well, that's quite clear that that's the pre-headline, so let's just grab out of our index sales example.php the %% tag for the pre-headline, control C, and just paste that into there, control V, and the next section is that, so that's the pre-headline we've just taken. The next section is the headline, which is build high converting sales pages, and that's that bit there. So what we're going to do is look for the %% headline tag, so we just control C that from there, and we'll replace the hard coded headline with a tag so we can edit it within WordPress. And then the next bit is this little bit of Latin here. Yep, that little bit of Latin there, and that's the subheadline. So let's just grab the subheadline tag, control C, and just replace that there. Okay, so let's just move that so it's the other way around. And what we're going to do is we're going to work our way through the content now, and we're going to, as I say, we're going to strip out these blocks of code here. So the first bit of code we've got goes down to dear friend. Yep, dear friend. So let's just shift that bit out of the way, and it's the div id equals box, so let's just grab that, control X to remove it, and now we're going to go into blocks.php and we're going to paste it in there. So we need to just tidy it up a little. Um, Yeah, okay, so the first thing we've got is the title, %% title tag. So, and that replaces the product features there, okay, which is hard-coded into the HTML version. We're replacing it with a tag that can be edited within WordPress, and that's what we're doing as we work our way through all of this. And then we've got here, we've got hard-coded images to product.png. Well, we're just going to replace that with another tag. And then we've got %% features, which is the this unordered list. Okay, so let's just tidy that up a little there. I like to have clean code because then you know where you stand with it all. Okay, opening div, closing div, opening div, closing div. Okay, Control X, and we're going to replace that product box. Okay, that's the first bit done. So I'm sure you'll agree already, this isn't difficult, it's just a matter of taking a bit of care. Okay, so the next section is down, the next block that we want is this one, which is a testimonial box. And we need to, so we need to remove this hard-coded code. Dear friend, this is a sample content. So here we go, dear friend, and it goes down to there. So let's just delete all of that. And then we're going to take that box code, which is the testimonial block, and we're going to insert it here. And within the code, it's called comment options. Okay, so we're going to take that %% title and we'll paste that in there. This is my comment, and that's that bit there. This is my comment. And then we're going to take the %% content and replace that there. Oh, there's a photo URL again. Let's just grab that and replace that. And then finally we've got signature. So let's just take that and that from there to there. Okay, and let's just clean the code up so we know where we are with it. Okay, let's just check opening and closing, opening and closing, p tag, opening and closing, and div. Okay, that's good. Code looks good, so we're now going to replace the comment options with that code. Now the nice thing is there are actually three comment options or testimonial sections, and they're all the same. Okay, so we can just copy and paste and replace the code. Okay, we're almost halfway through already. Okay, the next section is the certificate, the next block. So here's the certificate, 100% no questions asked, 60-day money back guarantee. So let's go into the index.php and we're going to remove, that's a testimonial box there, and we've already dealt with that. So we're going to go, this is a sample content, all the way down to there, and the certificate starts with that box ID and ends with this is a sample content down the bottom. So let's just make sure, yep, this is a sample content. Okay, so we're going to grab that, Control X, cut it, and let's give ourselves some room to work in. %% title, Control C, and that's that bit at the top there, 100% no questions asked. That's the title. Next section is there's some content, so we're going to take the content tag, %% content, and we're going to replace that all the way down to there. And then finally we've got the signature, which is this section here. So we take the %% signature tag and just put it in there. Okay, let's tidy that code up now. Okay, so we've got that, so it should be indented slightly, like I say, do like my clean code. Oh, that's right, that should be part of that line. So we've got a div and a closing div and a closing div, h2 and a close, p and a close with a break, div and a close, and then two closing divs. Good. Nice clean code. Cut it and replace what's in the certificate box. Move the lines and then give us some space to put the purchase section in. Okay, so the purchase section is, we've got some, this is a sample content, and then the purchase bit is the add to cart, the buy section, followed by PS. Okay, so let's go into index.php. So this is a sample content. That's all hard-coded HTML, so let's just remove that. And then we're here, div id equals box, right above the PS. Yep. So let's just cut that out and paste it in there, and then we'll clean it up. So yes, I want the WordPress sales page, that's the title section. Okay. Yes, I want the WordPress sales page title. So let's just replace that with a title tag. Then we've got content. So we'll replace that content. Then we've got a %% link, which is the when you click it. Oops, when you click the button, that's where it takes you off. Yeah, click. Okay. And then we've got this add to cart text here, this template, and you'll find many of them do, not all of them, have text overlaid on top of an image, and where it is, where it's done like that, then you can change that, and for that we use %% button text. So it's just grab that and add to cart, and then finally we've got a link off to the credit cards here, which is that image, and we've got a little tag called %% path URL with a slash at the end, which tells WordPress where the actual page template is stored within the WordPress installation. Okay, so that's what the path URL tells it, and then images credit.png, so it can find the files correctly. Okay, try removing it, see what happens. You'll get it then. Okay, let's tidy all these up. Let's put that on the line above. Image tag and closing div. Okay, and then there's one more div down at the bottom. I was just wondering where that was. Okay, so we've got div id box, div, h2 and a close, p and a close, div and a close, and that's it. Okay, we could actually clean that up a little bit more by putting that on the line underneath. Okay, and we put the break tags. Okay, that looks good. So let's copy that, Control X, and place the contents of the purchase block. Okay, so almost done. So we're now onto the, let's just save that. So now onto the PS down at the bottom here. And that is this little section here. So you can see it's got a signature in it as well. So there's the PS, that text, and the signature. So let's just grab all of that from there. Control X, go into the blocks. Give ourselves some space to work in. Okay, so we've got title. Do you know what? This looks exactly the same. It's the same bit of code. Div classical float right signature. Yeah, it's the same, but we'll do it anyway. Control C. Control V. Great, so it is in fact the same bit of code. But we'll insert it anyway. Right, nearly there, save that. Index.php, and the last section now is the footer. So I'm going to copy that. Okay. Not going to remove it. Going to blocks. And the reason we're copying it and not cutting it is because sometimes the footer may be part of the template and other times it could be a movable element. So in this particular case, the footer is part of the template. It's stuck right down at the bottom. Okay, so we've just taken that code out. So what we're going to do is we're just going to grab that %% footer, and you know what, it's exactly the same. Yeah, it is. But we'll do it anyway because that's the way a tutorial is supposed to work. Okay, that's that. So if I grab that now, I've just control C, that's save. And then I'm going to insert it here. Just highlight all that. There we go. Okay, let's refer back to the index.sales.example.php, and we can see that down here we've got, so I've done the right thing because div id footer, %% footer, div id footer, %% footer, but then down at the bottom we've got the %% wp footer. So let's just take that, and that goes immediately above the body tag. Normally that's a WordPress function that would take the contents of a WordPress function call, which includes things like JavaScript from other plugins. Okay, so the head we'll pull code in from WordPress, such as references to other plugins, okay, but it's right before the head tag, and WP footer does exactly the same right before the body tag, okay. So that's there to let you use plugins that use anything with JavaScript in. Okay, so now all we need to do, there is one more thing I've missed. You'll notice that here in the example, there's a %% main content. Okay, so we just need to grab that tag, and right in the middle of the content here, that's where it needs to go. Okay, so this is where your main sales copy would go that you edit in the TinyMC editor. And then within the TinyMC editor, you would add in shortcode tags for product, testimonial, and so on, wherever you wanted them to appear. Okay, whatever order you wanted them in, and then that entire section of sales copy would appear here where the main %% main content is. Okay, try it and you'll see. Right, the template is called PTP 011, I should say, so let's just change that, PTP 011. Is there anything else we need to do? I think that could pretty much be it. Have I done that? No, it's the star sheet here. Okay, so there's a %% path URL again. Control C. That goes in front of the star sheet, and as I said before, this tag tells WordPress and the plugin where the page template is actually located. Okay, this is the path to it. So we just paste that in right before the style sheet. So we just check now, we've got everything: title, path URL, WP head, content, footer, WordPress footer, the regular footer, pre-headline, headline, and the sub-headline, and then main content. Okay, so that looks pretty good to me. That looks like it's all done. So we'll just tidy the code up now and just make sure it's all well balanced, you know, closing divs and so on. So that one should be across a bit. That should be underneath there. Okay, so that section there is there, that should go in, that's there, that should go in one, which it has, so we'll just put that down a line, that can go across, then we have the content, the closing div. Closing div, and that's it. Okay, so let's just check that it all looks as it should. We've got HTML top and bottom, head, body and closing tag, div ID preheader with a closer, div ID wrapper with a closer, another div ID wrapper which ends down at the bottom there, that's good, div ID header which ends there, so let's just move that down a line and we'll pull that in. Okay, so that all looks pretty good. Div ID wrapper, that needs to be indented slightly. Div ID header, H1 tags, H2 tags, div ID content and close, div ID footer and close, and the closing tag for the wrapper. And that's it. That's the entire template done. Now that wasn't too difficult, I hope you'll agree. It's not taken that long to convert an entire HTML template into a format that can be used by the Unified Page Template plugin. And of course the flexibility you get once you've done that with being able to use the sales page template with any of your installations of WordPress is well worth that little bit of time that you've taken to do it. Now you may be doing this for a client, or you may be doing it for yourself with one of your existing templates, but I hope you'll agree it doesn't take too long to do, and it's not that hard to do either. Okay, there's just one more thing to do, and that's just to clean up the folder that we've been working in. So we no longer need the index.html and we no longer need the index sales example.php. And there we have it. You should end up with an index.php and a blocks.php, your style sheet plus your images. Okay, and then what you do is you'd zip up the ptp011 folder that you've been working in, and that is how you would then distribute it. The UPTP plugin has a built-in browser to allow you to upload zip files of templates. Okay, so you need to zip them up, and that's the way you distribute them. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Bye-bye.